Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with a Shopify tutorial video. And in today's video, I'm going to walk you through how you can optimize your Shopify store search result. And you can also optimize the product filters and product recommendation feature using a free app from Shopify called Search and Discovery. So that's an app which was released by Shopify last year, July 2022. And in this app, they have moved the filters from appearance navigation to this app. So if you are an OS 2.0 of Shopify, you should already have this app installed. I'm also gonna share some of the results from my client store and how I was able to suggest my customer that what you should do to optimize the search of your store and get more sale. So if you wanna learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. Okay guys, so that's how the reports of Search and Discovery app will look like. You will be able to see the search performance. You can see the date range of the search performance, that 22.68% is the click rate, whoever is searching on the store. And these are the top online store searches. And these are the top online searches with no results. Meaning someone searched these terms and didn't get anything, didn't find anything on your store so they could purchase. And as you can see, these are the top online searches with no clicks, meaning these searches were being done on your store, products were displayed, but those products were not relevant. And whoever did the search did not click on any of the products which were being displayed via search result. And that's the recommendation performance. So that's the search performance, and that's the recommendation performance, meaning the recommended area which shows up below the product. That's the click rate for that, and that's the purchase rate. So that's one of our client website, and I wanted to show you guys how the reports of Search and Discovery app will look like. Now I'm gonna head back to my development store and show you guys how you can install that app if you don't already have that app installed. You should by default have it if you are working on a latest OS 2.0 themes, meaning Dawn 9.0 or any of the latest Shopify themes. But if you don't have this app installed, then you should watch this video completely, in which I'm gonna show you guys how you can install that app and what further steps you can do to learn how these filters, search, and recommendation features work. Okay, let's get to the development store. So guys, that's my development store where I'm going to show you guys how you can install Shopify Search and Discovery app. So just go to search and search for Search and Discovery. And from there, you will have an option to search for this app in the Shopify app store. Click on that option. And from these search results, click on this one, Shopify Search and Discovery. Okay, now click on this Add App button. And here it will ask you to grant the permission for this app. Click on Install App. And here you go. Our Search and Discovery app has been installed. Now, first of all, let's try adding filters to your collections and searches pages. And in order to do that, from Search and Discovery app, click on this filters. And from there, it will ask you that which filters you want to add to your collection and searches pages. Now, let's go to our search page and see how our search page looks like without the filters. Now, I have some t-shirt products and I'm going to search for shirt. And that's how the search result is showing up on my store right now. I have Dawn 9.0 theme installed, which is the latest version. And as you can see, there are no filters on my search page right now. Now let's try adding some filters. Click on Add Filter. And then once you click on the source, it will show you all of the filter options available, which we have. The standard one are showing up here, availability, price, product type, tags, vendors. And for product options, we have color, denominations, size. And these are the meta fields, which we can also use in our filters. I'm going to talk about this product meta field sometime later, because that's another topic which is pretty detailed on how you can add custom meta field to your filters. Okay, now first let's work on the standard one. Now add in availability and add all of the standard ones which we have, so you guys can see how it changes the search and collection page of our store and what features you'll be able to see once you add all of these filters. And let's add in vendor as well. Add color, size, and denomination. So I just added all of the standard ones to our filters in order to show you guys how the search result will look like. So these are the search results without the filters. And now I'm going to open in a new tab and search for shirt again in order to show you guys what's the difference. Okay. Now you can see it's showing up all of the filters and the sorting options. We have availability, we have this price, we can add the range, we have more filters showing up where it's showing some of the names, brand, color. We can also filter our search result by color. We can filter our search result by size. So these are all of the standard ones which we added. By the way, these filters are showing up on our collection pages as well. So if you go to any of the collection pages, for example, I have this new collection pages. If I open that up, so these are all of the filters which we added. We can manage these filters from our filter section here within Search and Discovery app. Okay, now let's move to our search option here within Search and Discovery app. And once you click that, you have this option for product boost. And let me show you how it works. So click on product boost and then click on create product boost. Now select the product which you want to boost in your search result. Now, for example, if I search for blue, so I have this blue t-shirt. Now I'll check mark this, click on add button, and now I'll add the search terms which I want to optimize this product for. So for example, if someone add in term shirt, this product will show up on the top of our search result within our store. And if someone search blue, this product will also show up. And similarly, someone search for t-shirt, this product will show up on top of our search result. Now, once you add the search terms and select the product, click on save. And now if I go to my store and first let me refresh and search for blue. Now you can see our blue t-shirt is showing up on the top. Okay guys, so now let's move on to our recommendation in Search and Discovery app. Click on recommendations and here you can see we have product and this two columns. One is complementary products and related products. First, let me show you how the related product works. So if I open up this product, blue t-shirt, in this product, if I scroll down to the bottom, we have this section you may also like where these related products are showing up. These are auto-generated related products and we can customize these related products to only show up the ones which we want to display to our customer. Now, in order to customize it, I'm gonna go back here and in blue t-shirt, just select these and first click on that. And here we have option to customize our related products, edit our related products. So these are auto-generated ones. We can hide our auto-generated recommendations by clicking on this check mark. After hiding this, Let me display one of the product, which is not here. So in order to show you guys how you can customizably show, you may also like section. You can display only those products which you want to display on the section. Okay, now I want to display only this polo t-shirt on you may also like for blue t-shirt product, right? And hide all the auto-generated ones. I'll click on save. So after saving this, it's going to take like about 2 to 3 minutes in order to display your related products on your product. So I'm going to pause the video for a minute and then come back to this product and refresh. Okay, so after pausing like for 30 seconds, after refreshing, you can see now it's showing up only one product which I selected from this related product settings. Okay, now let me show you what is complementary products. Now, in order to display complementary product, you should have that on your customized settings. So let's go to our customized settings in our Dawn theme. So that's our theme. I'm going to click on customize. And from here, I'll select the product template, click on products, and then click on default product. You might have multiple templates. If you have, I'm going to go and add these complementary product section in my default product. Okay, once you load the default product template, you should have this complementary products block in your product information. So if you don't have that, it won't show up. But if you have this complementary products block added, it will show up the complementary products. Okay, now let me show you how it will look. So I'm adding complementary products on blue t-shirt. And let's select which one I want to show. Let's show up multiple products. So I'm going to display these 6 products on my complementary product section for blue t-shirt. Okay, all of these products are added. It's saying that $0 product won't show up, so I can remove that. It's saying that you selected the same product which is original. Okay, I can remove that as well. Now click on save and let's go to blue t-shirt. Okay, it's showing up now. Cool, you can see that that's the heading and these are the complementary product section which is showing up. It also has a cool sliding type thing which is showing up, 3 products in one slide. I think we should have settings as well. So if I go to product templates and click on complementary products, we have these settings showing up on how many products we can show and how many products we want to show per page. So if I select here 4 and pagination, we have pagination option as well. Select numbers, image ratio, portrait or square, pairs well with this product. Okay, icon, price tag, nice. Let's show a different icon like heart and now hit save to see how it looks on our product page. Okay, let me go to this product in our customized settings. Okay, it's showing up. Pairs well with this product. Now, if I change this number of product per page to 2, let's see. How it looks then. You can see that we have these 2 products showing up and then slider with numbers as pagination style, which we selected. And where is the icon showing up? Visible when collapsible row is displayed. Okay, show as collapsible row. Okay, that's nice. You can see that we have this as now collapsible row. Cool, right? So you can show your complementary products with the search and discovery app settings. This app is really cool if you want to optimize the search result of your Shopify store and try to get more sale. That's it about the search and discovery app. Let me know if you want to install this app or not, and which feature you will like to use the most on your store. Until next video, have a great day.